Rahman Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, everyone. Inshallah, in this second video, we will try to understand and learn about the attached pronouns. These are very important, so hence these need to be memorized and understood very well, because these attached pronouns comes a lot or frequently in Quran. So before I move on to the actual pronouns conjugation, I'll try to explain some three basic things slowly, and which will help going forward, inshallah. So we already knew that the Arabic verbs should fall in one of these three groups: the particle, or the verb, or the noun. So in Arabic we call ism, fail, and harf. So particle in English a, and the verb like went, it slept, and the noun can be a proper noun, the noun given to a person or a place, like Muhammadun, Bilalun, Fatimatu, Al Hind, Al Cairo, London, likewise. So having said that, all the nouns in Arabic, all the nouns in Arabic, so I'll use the term proper noun and a common noun. Proper noun refers to a name given to a person or a place, likewise, and common noun is other than the proper noun. So a book, a pen, door, car, likewise moon, sun, these I'll refer them as a common noun, inshallah. So all the common nouns and the proper noun should have the tanween at the end. So this is dhamma tanween, we say. So it is having two dhammas or two pesh in Asian continent, we say, because that explains the position of a noun in a sentence. So it is very important to understand that noun should have the tanween at the end. So we call in English case ending, case ending. So in here the dhamma tanween can be the tanween can be dhamma, the tanween can be fatha, that is zabar, double zabar, and the tanween can also be tamma, kasra tanween, that is double there. Okay, inshallah. So for that sake, here these are few common nouns. So khalamun means, whenever we have this tanween, it refers to a indefiniteness. So meaning that when we say khalamun, we are saying a pen, so we are not specific which pen. Likewise, the kitabun, it has the tanween at the end, so that means we are saying a book, so we are not very particular referring to a specific book. So these tanween can be dhamma, fatha, and kasra. Likewise, we'll see in the next step. So the first thing is, like all the nouns, either it be a proper noun like Muhammadun, Hamidun, Khalidun, Bilalun, those are the masculine proper nouns. And for the feminine proper nouns, the feminine Arabic proper nouns will not have dhamma tanween, instead it will have only one dhamma. So all the Arabic feminine names, the ending will be single dhamma. Inshallah, we'll see next how they are. So the masculine names will have the dhamma tanween, but feminine will have only one dhamma at the end. So it is very important to understand how the noun is ending with what sign, basically. So if we want to make a indefinite common noun, I am using here common noun, not the proper noun. So a pen, if I have to say the pen, meaning that we know what pen we are speaking or talking about. So in that case, we simply need to prefix al to that indefinite common noun. So here al is being prefixed to khalamun. So when al is being added, then the tanween has to reduce to single dhamma. So here it was dhamma tanween. So when a al has been prefixed, then we see that only single dhamma is there. So in a way, so if a noun has al, then it cannot have a tanween, and if a noun has a tanween, then it should not have al. So these two cannot coexist. So this is very important rule. A noun having al should not have a tanween at the end, and a noun having tanween will not have a al prefix to it, inshallah. So likewise, if we have to make a book, some book we don't know, to a particular book, then that need to be prefixed with al. And also the ending from bun has become bu here. So kitabun has become al kitabu. So this is the second thing we have seen now. First was that any word in Arabic should be classified in any of three groups: harf, ism, or fail. And the second concept we have just studied is making a indefinite common noun to a definiteness by prefixing al and taking off its one of the case ending tanweens. Alhamdulillah. So we will move on to the next bit here. So I just briefly explained above, the case ending is very important in Arabic. So the case ending can be fata, dhamma, or kasra, or in we can say zabar, zair, or pesh. Dhamma, fata, or kasra. So we have seen a book, kitabun, by prefixing al, it has become al kitabu here, the book. So likewise, this is a proper noun here, Muhammadun. So Muhammadun, it has the dun at the end, dhamma tanween, like a door, babun, by prefixing al and taking off one dhamma, it has become al babu. So a door, the door, a book, the book, and this is a proper noun, so we do not prefix al here for the proper nouns. Likewise, here in all these cases the ending was dhamma here. So likewise, the ending can also be fata, but there should be a reason why it will end with a fata or kasra. So likewise, here we see al kitaba, al kitabi, kitaban, kitabin, muhammadin, muhammadan, al baba, al babi, baban, babin. in the sense of meaning, there is no difference. So still this will say a book and the book. Muhammad is the proper noun, Muhammad, and a door, the door, having dhamma, fata, or kasra. In its true sense of meaning, it will not change, but it changes the meaning of the whole sentence where these signs represents its weight, inshallah. So we have just seen, like, this is the third concept we have seen, is that the ending case can be dun, dan, and din. Yeah. So here in Arabic, the nouns ending with dun or single or double dhamma, we call it a marfu or nominative case. so you don't really need to memorize these terms. But marfu is to say that the noun ending is having pesh. Either it can be a single or double dhamma tanwin. So zahava Muhammadun ila sukhi. So it means to say the Muhammad went to the market. Hamidun, this is a proper noun. Talibun is a common noun, a student. Muhammad is a hard-working student. So Mustahidun is again hard-working, having the double tanwin, double dhamma tanwin. Likewise, so this is a proper noun, this is a common noun, this is a common noun. And coming to the third example, Aminatu, because this is a feminine Arabic name, so this is a proper name, so hence it will not have dhamma tanwin, it will only have one dhamma at the end. It is important to remember that, inshallah. And Aminatu bintun jamilatun. So Amina is a beautiful daughter in a sense, inshallah. So this was about the marfu. The same can also be said mansub, that is the accusative case. We call it English. Ra'aytu Muhammadan fissukhi. So here this is a verb and this is a proper noun. So I saw Muhammad in the market. So suhun was the common noun, market, because it has prefixed al. So for that reason it has taken single dhamma because of some having the harf jar fi, so it has taken the kasra. So don't get into much of complications at the moment, inshallah. In the future videos we'll try to understand those things. So the only thing trying to explain here is, like, in one sentence the Muhammadun has the dhamma tanwin, in the second Muhammadan has single has fatha tanwin, and in another sentence it became kasra tanwin. Coming to excuse me, the feminine names here, so it has single single dhamma here. And so you need to remember that these feminine names will have single dhamma. And but the other important thing we should be remembering, the names having the single dhamma at the end will not decline like three ways, like dun, dan, din. So if aminatu has to decline, then it will be either aminatu or Amenata. It can never be Amenati. So I repeat again, the nouns having single dhamma in its natural form, if it has to decline, we call this declination of noun. So it can be Amenatu in its true natural form. For any specific reason, if it has to decline, then it can decline and become Amenata, but it can never become Amenati. So yeah, I think pretty much this is what I wanted to explain. So remember these three things which I just explained. Just to reiterate, the first is, like, the words are categorized in one of these three groups: harf, noun, harf, ism, and fail. And every noun should have the tanwin at the end. Ideally, every noun should have tanwin at the end, so that if it is a proper noun, name of a person or place, then nothing to worry about. But if it is a common noun, then that will give a sense of something, a book or a door or a car. If you have to make it definite, then we prefix that common noun with al, and we take off one of its dhamma, and one of its dhamma. Kitabun becomes al-kitabu. And the proper nouns and all the other nouns will decline, like Muhammadun, Muhammadan, Muhammadan. Inshallah, we'll study why they decline with these three ways, inshallah. So having said that, we will move on to our conjugation, attached conjugations here. So this attached conjugation form, so we are saying that this attached conjugation here, these can be attached to either harf or ism or a verb. So what we have just studied, the first category, so these attached pronouns can be attached to a noun, a verb or a harf, not all but few harfs or particles. So that's the reason I had to explain those three. So it is very important to understand and memorize these attached pronouns, which are very frequently used, inshallah. So we'll begin, inshallah. So already we are aware that the first index finger represents the third person absent masculine, and the middle finger represents third person feminine, ring finger represents second person masculine, and the little or pinky finger represents second person feminine, and the thumb represents the first person or the person or the person speaking. So either it can have singular or the dual, inshallah. So the first bone of the four fingers represent a singular person, and the two bones represent the middle bone, or the second bone represents the dual or the two persons, and the third is for the plurals, which is to say three or more people, inshallah. So here the meanings of these attached pronouns are slightly changed from the detached pronouns. So huwa, in the attached pronoun it was to say he, but here we say his. So who means his, huma means they two, whom means they all, ha means her. So in detached pronouns here it was hia, but in attached pronoun it is ha. So in the detached pronouns it was she, but here in the attached pronouns this has become her. And huma means to say the same, they too. Hunna means to say they all. So if you have observed, then these four are common to attached and detached pronouns. So in the detached pronouns we said huwa, huma, hum, hiya, huma, hunna, but here we would be saying hu, huma, hum, ha, huma, hunna. So it is a little easy because the third person, second, and the plural, duals and the plural are pretty much same. So inshallah we will move on to the second person. So here referring to a brother, the person in front, this being an attached pronoun, ka means here it will be yours. It will be yours or your. So kuma means you both. You both. Kum means you all. This is for the masculine, and the feminine is ki, you, when speaking or talking to a sister, ki. Kuma is again same for the duals, second person, kuma, kuma. And kunna is to is for the all the sisters in the front or whom we are speaking. So it will be ka, kuma, kum, ki, kuma, kunna. Ka, kuma, kum, ki, kuma, kunna. Also, I urge you to remember or memorize these English meanings as well along with it. So here it's not you, here it is your, you two and you all. So inshallah we will move to the first person. Here it will be ya. So we, for the tune sake, we'll say e, but ya. And here for plural it will be na. Na. So for singular it is e. So in the detached pronouns we have said I or myself, but here in the attached pronouns it will be mine to say e, and na will be to say us here. Inshallah. So e na. So inshallah I'll try to explain, run through this through a tune which will inshallah help you in this regard. So huwa huma hum, that was for the detached pronouns. So here it will be hu huma hum, ha huma hunna, hu huma hum, ha huma hunna, ka kuma kum, ki kuma kunna, ka kuma kum, ki kuma kunna, ina, ina. Again, one more time. Hu huma hum, ha huma hunna, ka kuma kum, ki kuma kunna, ina, ina. One more time again, inshallah, because this is very important. So this comes very frequently, so it's very important to understand and memorize this. Hu huma hum, ha huma hunna, ka kuma kum, ki kuma kunna, ina, ina. Inshallah, so we'll end up here. In next videos we'll see how these attached pronouns are used in forming construction and conjugation. From now on, most of our conjugations will depend on these attached pronouns, and which will help understand some good concepts inshallah going forward. So hope you will benefit from this video and try to practice and memorize this tune inshallah. Till our next video, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.